go. This is an AM tower. I don't even remember the frequency. 560 or something like that. That may or may not be the right one. I don't know. Now, why did I put that around the beacon? To give me a little more height. And give me a little bit of support in the work position. And all my legal stuff. My fall lanyards, which are in excellent shape, because they've never been tested, by somebody falling, that is. Okay, if I were to fall with these fall lanyards, they would be ruined. So that's another reason why I don't want to fall, is I don't want to have to buy more lanyards. About $250 these days for those things. So, now we're going to start down the tower. It's a little more tedious than climbing up, actually. Using the double hooking method. So I might go to fall prevention and then fall restraint. Yep, I think I'm going to. And if my little friend with 4 years experience doesn't like it, he just have to report me to somebody. Okay? There you go. I do see a benefit now, though. I'm not having a stretch. Now, this, by the way, is not as good as fall prevention because I'm going to put the hook down as far as I can get it because I'm trying to get off this thing and it won't work as well if it's below my head. The hook's supposed to be over your head, so how can you use it climbing like that? Okay, plus it's fouled on my bag as well, so now it's time to straighten out the hooks again. Do-do-do-do. Oh yeah. There we go. That one is okay, the other one wasn't. Now, once again, we continue down. Still got a problem over here I need to fix. This has very little to do with doing my work. It's everything to do with trying to do it legally. So, how can I get this out of the way? I guess I gotta do this. Okay, I'm just going to go back on the back of the harness, between the ball lanyards. Over here. There it is. A couple old D-rings back there on the harness. Now, continuing this oddity, I guess. Thank you. I prefer a safety cable, but you can't put a safety cable on an AM tower unless you got one of the non-conductive ones. This doesn't work. And AM, the antenna, the tower is the antenna. And FM and TV, the tower holds up the antenna. It's a support for an antenna. Hard on the hands. Oops, went a little too far, didn't I? Climb back up again. Man, one whole step. Wow. Once again, we're passing the taps. Look up and see how the antenna's configured. Okay, what am I doing here? Oh yeah, resting. I think this thing has been welded, but I can't say for sure. Yeah, I could drip a bead right there. Sometimes AM towers are welded together for better conductivity for the antenna aspect, which is the whole aspect, actually. That's right, I was gonna rest and forgot. Man, how could I forget resting? Boss will get all over me. Oh, I am the boss. Dang old boss. Another rest. Hard on the hands, hard on the hands. Glad I got this done, man. My very good customer will not, fear his lights being out. Aching hands down to the lights, at least. It'd be nice if they'd mandate non-conductive safety cables, but that's not going to happen. got the rest again, darn it. Forget the rest. Messed up again. I messed up again. Okay, now I'm going to remember the rest. Whew. Got two more painted sections to go. 250 feet. 1/7. 60 feet maybe. Yeah, about that. Whew. Yeah, not very far. This thin, I want to use both my hands. Painful. this. I'm going to free climb the rest of the way. Yeah, about 3 feet up. Boy, my hands are going to be sore for a while. Okay, done. Another re-lamping in the thousands I've probably done over the years.